Yeah. ওখানে একটু ক্লোজিং সাজিয়ে দেয়, আর নিচে ওইখানে গেটে নাটকের সামনে খাল করছে। इसके पश्चात हम लोगों के गुरु वर्जन की तिथि आ रही है, जो हमारे और उसके साथ साथ दूसरे दिन फिर तीसरे दिन आएगा शिष्य महाराज भक्ति विधान से भक्ति से रोम सिद्धांत महाराज की आविर्भाव से थी। ये सब तिथियां पालन करने के पश्चात हम लोग फिर यात्रा में निकलेंगे, जो कि खामोलन की यात्रा में पालन। तो आज मेरी इच्छा है कि वैष्णव जन कुछ बताएंगे। आज एक ड्रामा डेंट होने की बात है तो हमने सुना था तो होगा, पर तो अभी वैष्णव जन कुछ बताए, क्योंकि आज पत्रकार और टीवी चैनल वाले भी आए थे। उन्होंने कहा कि भगवान कृष्ण ने जैसे गिरिराज जी की पूजा करवाई ब्रजवासियों से, ये सब बातें तो हम लोग सुनते आए हैं और देते रहे हैं, परंतु नई तरीके से आप दो शब्दों में कुछ बताइए, जो कि टीवी प्रसारण में सारी दुनिया को जाए। तो उस समय उन्होंने कोई प्रश्न भी किया था, जो कि हमने बताया कि हमारा ये जो सनातन संस्कृति है, यह सनातन संस्कृति केवल हमारी भारतीय परंपरा की, केवल भारतीय नहीं कहेंगे, यह सनातन संस्कृति जो है यह हमारी विश्व की संस्कृति है। संपूर्ण विश्व के एक एक कोने से एक एक राष्ट्र के कितने कितने भक्त समुदाय आए हैं, और यह विश्व की संस्कृति है गिरिराज गोवर्धन की पूजा। गिरिराज गोवर्धन की पूजा में भगवान ने जो बात कही है, क्यों हम गिरिराज जी की पूजा करें, सबसे पहले हम प्रत्यक्ष देवता का आदर करना सीखें। जो यहाँ हमारे यहाँ सुबह से कार्य करते, पहले गुरु की पूजा, फिर ब्राह्मण और गाय की पूजा, क्योंकि गौ माता जीवन भर हमें दूध पिलाते, जिसकी वो हमारी माता है, बहन हमारी पिता है, गुरुजन हमारे सर्वस्व है, हृदय के देवता है, गुरु पाल पत्व हमारे हृदय देवता है। हमने किसी ने भी भगवान को सामने सामने दर्शन नहीं किया, परंतु गुरु जी को हमने सामने दर्शन किया, उनका सान्निध्य लाभ किया, उनसे वार्ताएं हुई, उनकी शिक्षा हमने ग्रहण किया, इसलिए वे हमारे जीवन के देवता है, हम सबके देवता है। अगर उनके प्रति हमारी वैसी भावना होनी चाहिए, ऐसी निष्ठा, इसी प्रकार सर्व मानव समस्त प्राणियों के प्रति भी हमारी निष्ठा होनी चाहिए, जो कि सर के प्रति आदर हो, सम्मान, प्राणियों में सद्भावना हो, कैसे होगी परमात्मा से अन्य सबके हृदय विराजमान। जो परम पर्वत जिसके द्वारा हमारे जीवन की सुरक्षा होती है, उनको हम देवता रूप में हमारे आनंद रूप में हम पूजा कर रहे हैं, उनके अंदर भी भगवान श्री विराजमान। जो कि ब्रज के अंदर भगवान ने जिनकी इतनी महिमा बढ़ाई, जो कि हजार से वज्र गिरिराज गोवर्धन और जहाँ की तलहटी में जहाँ की कंदराओं में भगवान राधा कृष्ण की अवकाश लीलाएं हुई। आज कभी लीला कथाओं को सुनने के लिए हम प्रयासी हैं, कि वैष्णव लोग कुछ नई नई बातें सुना, ये कथा नहीं सुनाई पड़ेगी, जो पुरानी हो गई है, जो बार बार कहा जा रहा है, नई नई लीला कथा। तो आप सुनाएंगे।
ओम शांतिरात्रस्य ज्ञानांजनाय चक्षुर्मीलितं तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकाय सदाहरे कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय धर्मभक्ताय नमो नमः। सो आई एम ऑर्डर्ड
Worrying about all the gopis. It's better that we take Radhika alone, because Radhika is equal to
all the gopis, anyone superior to them, combined together. So he left all the gopis and he took only Radhika on his head and he was running. But Krishna told Balaram, you look after all these gopis, they are very scared. Then Krishna chased this particular yaksha till Shankar Shat portal. And then, just by one swipe and one blow, and he took off his head and also the jewel which was on his head. And that was the Samantha jewel. So this Samantha jewel is eternally the jewel of Srimati Radhika. But just like the Kaustubha jewel which was on the chest of Krishna was given to Krishna by the wife of Kaliya. Because Kaustubha jewel is the eternal ornament of Sri Krishna's chest. So, even Lord Narayana has Kaustubha jewel, but it's an expansion of the original Kaustubha jewel which is on the chest of Sri Krishna. So this Samantha jewel, Krishna had to give it to Radhika. But Krishna thought, if I give it to Radhika, then big problem will come and other gopis may observe Maan. So better that I give it to Balaram, then Balaram is very clever and he will make sure that you reach Radhika. So Krishna gave that Samantha jewel to Balaramji. Balaramji gave it to Madhumangal, Madhumangal gave it to Lalita, Lalita gave it to Rupamanjari, and then it came to Radhika. So it always blessing the chest of Srimati Radhika, this Samantha jewel. Later on, when Krishna went from Vrindavan to Mathura, in separation of Krishna, Radhika could not tolerate the separation from Krishna. So Radhika, she became very distressed. She said, what is this? My beloved is gone to Mathura and he doesn't even remember me. So better that I commit suicide. So Radhika jumped in the Kela Tirtha. That actually there is a lake in Jamuna. In that Kela Tirtha Radhika jumped. So that Samantha jewel was on the chest of Srimati Radhika. And then Jamuna, she is a good friend of Radhika. As Vasudeva Vishnupada explained that Vishapa Rasya Vishnu Yasam Nitya Jalatmani Nityam Nimajati Kritya Nam Sauri Yamnam Suma. That is daughter of sun planet, the sun god, is actually Jamuna. So Jamuna thought that this is my beloved Sri Radhika, let me take her to the sun planet. Immediately Radhika was taken to the sun planet. There Radhika was always feeling separation from Krishna. And that jewel, Samantha jewel, was also handed over to the sun god. That time, the sun god's wife, Sadhya, she told, alas, alas, that your Sakhi is so beautiful, but why she is so distressed all the time? And Vishaka told that she is looking for Krishna. She is always thinking of Krishna. So then Sadhya, the wife of sun god, told that they are to see Surya Narayan, that is Puram Narayan, Shankar Chakra Gada Padma, living on the sun planet. She should see Narayan and she should become happy. But then Vishaka told, no, that Narayan cannot satisfy. She only wants to see Sri Krishna who has a top feather on his head and his flame float. Puranta Bhavam Shiro Madhur Bhavata Dhavaveha. Vidanta Mandala Gunavari Pati Maragita Nesheshi Chandraka Shirati Deva Vedam Bukhe Na Dhatu Rachana Tamo Sakhi Manaya Mandela. That Radhika is telling that if here people can be interested, girls can be interested in so many boys who have no peacock feather, no yellow garment, and who are not standing in default waiting for. But I am only interested in that boy who has all these qualities. So, Gopinam Pashupendra Vimadan Yusho Bhavasana Sthanukti Vidnyatam Shavate Duruha Padavim Sanchariyam Takriya Avish Purvati Vaishnavi Tanum Tasmin Bhuja Vishnavi Yasa Mahanta Chantur Vira Vajyam Rahu Vem Kunchari. That gopis, when they see the Puram form of Krishna, the Rahu, the spontaneous love in their heart will become contracted. As we see in Vaita also, that Krishna's Puram form could not attract the gopis. So wife of the sun god told, so Vishaka told Satya that she cannot be attracted. One time Srimati Radhika was feeling so much separation from Krishna. And Purnamasi told her, hey Radhika, why don't you worship Narayan? Then Radhika said, what is the purpose of worshipping Narayan? I have given my life as gold to Krishna. But then Purnamasi said that you loved him so much that he left you and gone to Mathura, he doesn't even remember you. So, Radhika told that you are telling me to remember Narayan, but remember Gargacharya, what he told. Gargacharya told that Narayan is Samay Gunai. There is no difference between Krishna and Narayan. If Krishna is Narayan Samay Gunai, Krishna is equal to Narayan in qualities, then what's the point in remembering Narayan? I remember only Krishna. But Gurudamashi told that although you are remembering Narayan, although you are remembering Krishna, Krishna is a cheater. He may cheat you. But Narayan will never cheat his devotees. Narayan is always obedient, he is always Lakshmi Nayak. But Krishna is Vaminayak and doing so many tricks. That time Srimati Radhika told Purnamasi Devi, Ashvishava Padasam Virashtavam Adarshanam Varamadam Karutuva Yatha Tathava Vidhadu Lampato Matranananda Susayavadam. That he may embrace me, or he may embrace some other devotee in front of me. And by embracing some other devotee right in front of my eyes, he may break my heart. But he is my lifetime, after lifetime he is my beloved. I cannot accept anyone else. So, finally this Samantha 12 was given to Satrajit. And Satrajit also was bestowed a daughter, that is Satyavama. She is also a manifestation of Radhika. So as you see that these qualities of Vamya Bhava is so much prominent in Vrajaras. And therefore, Srimati Radhika was Vadu Sneha. She gains an upper hand in Vraja pastimes. But Chandravani, she is Kruta Sneha. And she has a lower position in Vraja Nila. But then again, in Dwarka Nila, that Vamya Bhava is not so useful because it is a wedded love. And there, Vamya Bhava doesn't get so much prominence. So there, Rukmini is superior and Satyabhama is then lower there. So this Govardhan, it has been said that Govardhan was like the Shaira Sudhati Aso, Jo Kotika Vibhidho Harinath Sumari. There are so many mountains in India. Himalaya is even taller. Meru mountain is there. Mandala mountain is so many big, big mountains are there. But Sri Giriraj has been given the topmost position. Sri Giriraj has been given topmost position not just because Sri Giriraj is very tall. As you know now that Giriraj is very, very now short. Previously Giriraj Govardhan used to be very tall. Even the demigoddesses who are flying in airplanes, they used to complain, alas, alas, the Giriraj peaks are so tall that our airplanes crash against it. But now, many times people tell that on your temple altar, we see see the beautiful face of Radha Krishna, and we also see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is here. But where is Nityananda Prabhu? Let me tell them that Gurudev is present there as Nityananda Prabhu. Because Sri Gurudev is not even a manifestation of Nityananda Prabhu.
Standing on top of Giriraj Govardhan and he wants to catch me.
That time Narada told that you are completely mad. Where is Krishna? I don't see Krishna at all. Vasa Vitam Patikalikutaha Uttravaram Madante Kamsa Yudva Kusatimha Kambraman Mahatayahi Pashatunge Shadatata Nikita Shaitashunge Navya Shadra Mundadu Lente Kaham Kambad Kesha. The Nadika told that there is no Krishna there. You just see that there is very beautiful rain cloud is there, and that rain cloud is mistaken to be Krishna. But Nadika told that I saw the peacock feather. The Narita told there is no peacock feather there. There is the rainbow is there which has seven colors in it, and peacock feather also has seven colors in it. So all these seven colors, they are appearing to you as if they are peacock feather and Krishna is standing there. So Srimati Radhika, she will feel so much separation from Krishna. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he was at Govardhan, and then near Govardhan he went to Arithaka. Aritha means that is where Arishtasura was killed by Krishna. And there he saw two fields, one black field and one white field. And when he saw this black field and white field, he was very ecstatic. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu began to dance ecstatically. That time Sri Bhakti Rasasundara Maharaj has written it. Prema Mukta Mritya Kirtana Pura Vitantikam Snana Dhanya Vali Dhanya Bhumi Kunda Deshakam Prema Kunda Ravika Shastra Vandana Adaram Prema Dhamma Deva Prema Naumi Gaura Sundaram Prema Dhamma Deva Prema Naumi Gaura Sundaram Prema Dhamma Deva Prema Naumi Gaura Sundaram Prema Mukta Mritya Kirtana Pura Vitantikam. Mahaprabhu became very ecstatic. And he realized that this is the place where Arishtasura was killed by Krishna, that by himself. And he bearing those two legs, one was the white field and another one was the black field. And he identified the black field as Krishna Kunda. And he identified the white field as Radha Kunda. So, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he personally discovered these two, Radha Kunda and Shyam Kunda. Before Mahaprabhu came, Loknath Goswami also had come there, and so many other Goswamis, but no one revealed the glories of Radha Kunda and Shyam Kunda. They kept the glories of Radha Kunda and Shyam Kunda only for Mahaprabhu to be discovered. One time, Jambavan, as we know that Jambavan is present in Lord Ram's pastime and is also present in Krishna's pastimes. So one time Jambavan came to Govardhan. And top of Govardhan, he saw one very beautiful gopi. And she was in a dangerous situation. She was about to jump off the cliff of Gira and commit suicide. That time, Jambavan told, "Hey, you are my daughter. Why are you committing suicide?" And that girl was no one else but our Narita. So Jambavan immediately grabbed her and took her to Jammu. And where she was placed in the cave there. So Jambavan gave her two deities. One deity was golden deity of a young girl and one was a black deity. And this black deity made of Indra Neelamani, blue sapphire. And she was doing her deity worship the way, in a particular way. She will go something and she will whisper something in the ear of this golden deity. And then hear some message from this golden deity and will bring it to the black deity, that is Krishna. And in this particular way, this particular Narita Devi, she was worshipping Radha Krishna. But later on, she took the name Jambavati because she was now adopted by Jambavati. So, this Giraj Govardhan is the place where Rasila takes place. As you know, Rasila Tattva is very deep, but Rasila is of two types. One is Nitya Ras and one is Maharas. Maharas is also of two types. One is Shardiya Ras and one is Vasantik Ras. As you know that the Shardiya Ras has been described by Shri Shukadeva Goswami, in Srimad Bhagavatam. Sri Shukadeva Goswami has described Sri Sharadiya Maharaj and Sri Jayadeva Goswami has described Vasantik Maharaj in his Gita Govinda. But in Gola Vrindavan there is Nitya Ras, that Rasa is always taking place. So, in Vrindavan the Rasa is always going on. Every Purnima night Rasa is arranged. Rasa takes place only on Purnima day. So, Tadi Nitya Vihara Veda Tanute Vrindavan Madhavo, Postam Bhojo, Uchivirti Manas, Bhoji Priyaya Haram, Vila Lakshya Rasatam, Vrindavate, Vyas Vyam Pashar, Tatpa Yogi Puram Karaka Gavan, Vyajashta Vyasati. That although it is not pastime of Sri Krishna going in Vrindavan and in Govardhan, but Sri Shukadeva Goswami has not described them elaborately. Because knowing that Vrindavane Mukundasya Nitya Inda Virajate, Spashta Nesha Rahasyatva Jnanasya Abhi Manchate, that in Vrindavan eternal pastimes of Sri Krishna are going on, but these pastimes are so confidential that Sri Shukadeva Goswami has sent Krishna to Mathura and to Dwarka. So, this Govardhan, as you know in Vaikata, that is where the Vasantik Raj has taken place. And all the Nitya Sita Gopis, Chandravali and Padma Shantya, and then all the Radhika, Adhita, Vishakha, all the Nitya Sita Gopis, they have participated in the Rasa Lila Govardhan. But even superior to Govardhan is Sri Radhakund. Because in Radhakund, the pastimes of Sri Krishna are even more. Radhika's prominence is there in Radhakund. And no opposing forces can come to Radhakund. So, it is very difficult to describe the glories of Giriraj Govardhan. But, as we know, that Sri Gurudev has ordered us that all of you should go and do Abhishek. One time I remember, I was at Dhamghati and for Abhishek we went there and I was a little bit behind because there was so much crowd. So many devotees were trying to bathe Giriraj Govardhan. And Gurudev looked at me and he told me, have you bathed Giriraj yet? I said, I'm going to there. So, Sri Gurudev is very particular. He is telling us that you must surrender to Giriraj Govardhan. Because Sri Giriraj Govardhan is Sarva Abhishta Pradarsha. And as we see in Navadvip also, the Golokit is actually the hidden Govardhan. And Sri Gurudev has built a mud there in Golokit. This Golokit is not different from Govardhan. So, both the mud, the biggest of Sri Gurudev's muds are present in Govardhan. Srila Gurudev's heart is Govardhan. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada also always used to utter Nijanikata Nivasam Dehi Govardhanatmam Nijanikata Nivasam Dehi Govardhanatmam. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada also always used to pray to Giriraj Govardhan. So our entire Guru Parampara, the heart is Giriraj Govardhan. We offer serious obeisances at the lotus feet of Giriraj Govardhan and pray at the lotus feet of Giriraj Govardhan. Then all the obstacles in our heart and our spiritual life will be removed by the mercy of Giriraj Govardhan. Shri Gurudeva Ki Jai.
Chakshur Nitya Tasmai Shri Guru.
ब्रह्मा विष्णु पदाय राधिकाय श्रीहर्षणे श्रीमद् भक्ति कथा नारायण गोस्वामी श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य श्री अद्वैत गौर हरे कृष्ण
जैसे कृष्ण वृंदावन में रहते हैं और
क्षणिक से वो द्वारका की लीला भी करते हैं अपने विस्तार से अपने एक्सटेंशन से। जैसे गुरुदेव मूल में परिक्रमा में है और अपने एक एक छोटे से स्वरूप से वो स्वस्थ लीला करते हैं। मैं ये नहीं कह रहा मैं सिद्धांत की बात कर रहा हूँ, ये मैं अपने विचार भी प्रकट कर रहा हूँ। वैष्णव लोग इसको काटेंगे तो मैं समझने की कोशिश करूंगा। श्री गुरुदेव बतलाते हैं दामोदर रस का जो कि हम कार्तिक के मास में पढ़ते हैं वो एक क्रमबद्ध प्रार्थना है। शुरू होती है नमामि से, वैदिक भक्ति नमस्कार से शुरू होती है और उसमें भी ईश्वर को प्रणाम है जिसके अभी स्वरूप का ज्ञान नहीं है, लेकिन इस प्रणाम की निष्ठा के कारण तुरंत प्रार्थी को भगवान के दर्शन हो जाते हैं और वो कहता है सच्चिदानंद रूप, वो ईश्वर का रूप उसको दिखाई देने लग जाता है वो सच्चिदानंद। और इस तरह से क्रम से उसको गोकुल में दौड़ते हुए कृष्ण दिखते हैं, फिर पीछे से यशोदा जी दिखती है, फिर वो बंधते हैं, रस्सी एक ऐसी है जो कृष्ण के उदर को बांध देती है और प्रार्थना बढ़ती चली जाती है। गोकुल धाम का दृश्य और दृष्टव्य होता चला जाता है, बहुत स्पष्ट होता जाता है। अंत में उनको राधा जी की महिमा दिखाई देती है और वो राधा जी की महिमा को गाकर अपना दामोदर रस क्रम समाप्त करते हैं। ऐसे ही गुरु महाराज जी ने एक ही सबसे पहले मथुरा में श्री केशव त्रिगोड़ मठ की स्थापना की, वहां से भजन प्रक्रिया शुरू हुई, उसके बाद रूप सनातन गौड़िया मठ में वृंदावन ने भक्ति को और प्रकाश किया और अब गिरधारी गौड़िया मठ वीर गिरिराज गोवर्धन ने लाकर भक्ति की सर्वश्रेष्ठ स्थल पे आकर अपने सारे भक्तों को जाने का निश्चय कर दिया है। मैं ऐसे महसूस करता हूँ हमारे गुरु महाराज जी हमारे जितने भी उनके शिष्य हैं उनके भक्तगण हैं उनकी भक्ति का एक एक पल ख्याल रखते हैं। उन्होंने इतने साल हमको सिद्धांतों की शिक्षा दी, कभी मन शिक्षा सुनाया, कभी उपदेशामृत सुनाया, कभी भजन रहस्य सुनाया। और भजन रहस्य को सुनाते समय उन्होंने कहा भजन की परिपाटी है कि विरहा में कोई अच्छी तरह से भजन करे। हमारे गौड़िया संप्रदाय में भजन की पुष्टि विरह भाव से काटर भाव से भगवान को पुकारने से ही सिद्ध होती है। मात्र स्तुतियां मात्र जाप से काम नहीं होता, जब हृदय में पूरा विलोड़न होता है और हृदय पूरा मशीनीकृत हो जाता है, मक्खन पिघल के आंखों में आंसू के रूप में निकलता है, वही प्रेम में मक्खन जो आंसू के रूप में प्रकट होता है उसको ही गौड़िया संप्रदाय में भजन कहते हैं। ये बहुत सिद्धांत उनको गुरुदेव ने सिखाए, आज वो अपनी अस्वस्थ लीला से हम लोगों को उसे प्रैक्टिकल करने की शिक्षा दे रहे हैं। मैं ऐसा समझता हूँ कि हम किस तरह से गुरु महाराज जी को अपने हृदय में लेकर उनके अस्वस्थ भाव से एकदम हृदय को भाव गर्भित करके और उनकी चाह में उनके दूर रहते हुए भी करीब लाकर और विनय भाव से हम उनको याद करें, छठा दर्शन भी दिखाते हैं और फिर चढ़वाए भी हैं और हम अपने भजन को आगे बढ़ाए। यही गिरिराज गोवर्धन की तलहटी पे मेरे पहले हमारे गुरु महाराज जी हमें शिक्षा देना चाहते हैं। श्री रमन बिहारी गौड़िया मठ में गुरुदेव जी अस्वस्थ लीला कर रहे थे। 4 तारीख को परिक्रमा ने यहाँ आना था गिरिराज गोवर्धन में और 3 तारीख को कहते हैं चलो गोवर्धन, कोई दवाई काम नहीं करेगी, चलो गोवर्धन। माधव महाराज जी को कहा, ब्रजनाथ को बोला लेट अस गो टू गोवर्धन, माधव महाराज को फिर ब्रज में भी बंगला में भी बोला गोवर्धन चलते हैं, मतलब 3 बार चलो गोवर्धन। और जब कहा गया कि गोवर्धन जाने की तैयारी कर रहे हैं, उसने कह दी मन गोवर्धन में आएगी। ये एक्सीडेंट नहीं, गुरुदेव की पूरी की पूरी प्लानिंग है। गुरु महाराज क्या क्या लीला कर रहे हैं, कई लोगों के मन में तरह तरह के भाव, तरह तरह के विचार जागृत होते हैं। मुंह उठाते हैं, आंख खोलते हैं और पूछते हैं कीरत महाराज जी से, तुम बड़ी परमा पे नहीं गए? महाराज जी जा रहा हूँ। अच्छा, और फिर खो जाते हैं, हमें नहीं दिखाई देता कहां खो जाते हैं। लेकिन जो जो अच्छी तरह से इस विचार को जानेंगे और हमारे सारे आचार्यों की पूरी जीवन प्रणाली को देखेंगे तो पता चलेगा गुरु महाराज जी हमारी किस तरह की लीला कर रहे हैं, वो हमसे क्या चाहते हैं, कैसा चाहते हैं। आज इस गोवर्धन की महिमा में गुरु महाराज जी हमेशा एक बात बताते थे, जो उसी बात को मैं थोड़े यहाँ पे समर्पित करके उनको याद कर रहा हूँ। जैसे वही ये कहना चाहते हैं, कुछ लोग गिरिराज गोवर्धन को भगवत स्वरूप के रूप में मानते हैं।